Today we will see CBSE class 12 legal studies unit 1 judiciary. To understand the following concepts: common law, adversarial system of law, due process of law, public interest litigation, impartiality of judges, judicial review, separation of powers, division of powers, checks and balances, basic structure, collegium system in appointment of judges, impeachment. Supreme Court of India, High Court, District and Subordinate Courts, Civil Courts, Criminal Courts, Specialized Tribunals, Service Tax, Consumer, Labor. A. Structure, Hierarchy of Courts and Legal Offices in India. 1. Structure and Hierarchy of Courts in India. The Constitution of India lays out the framework of Indian judicial system. India has adopted a federal system of government which distributes the law, enacting the power between the center and the states. Yet the Constitution establishes a single integrated system of judiciary comprising of courts to administer both central and state laws. The Supreme Court, located in New Delhi, is the apex court of the India. It is followed by various high courts at the state level, which function for one or more number of states. The high courts are followed by district and subordinate courts, which are known as the lower courts in India. To supplement the functioning of the courts, there exist specialized tribunals to adjudicate sector-specific claims such as labor, consumer, service matter disputes. Supreme Court of India. The Supreme Court of India came into being on 28 January 1950. It replaced both the Federal Court of India and the Judicial Committee of the Privy Council, which were at the apex of the Indian court system under the colonial era. The Constitution of India, as it stood in 1950, envisaged a Supreme Court with the Chief Justice and 7 judges. The Parliament was granted the power to increase the number of judges in the coming years. At present, the total strength of the Supreme Court is 31 judges, including the Chief Justice of India. High Courts. India consists of 24 high courts at the state and union territory level. Each high court has jurisdiction over a state, a union territory, or a group of states and a union territories. Below the high courts exist a hierarchy of lower courts functioning as civil courts and criminal courts, as well as the specified specialized tribunals. The Madras Court in Chennai, Bombay High Court in Mumbai, Kolkata High Court in Kolkata, and अहमदाबाद हाई कोर्ट इन अहमदाबाद आर द फर्स्ट फोर हाई कोर्ट्स इन इंडिया. डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स एंड सब कोऑर्डिनेट कोर्ट. The courts that functions below the High Court are popularly known as the lower court. They consist of district and subordinate court. Each state is divided into judicial districts presided over by a district and sessions judge. The judge is known as district judge when she or he presides over a civil case and a session judge when he presides over a criminal case. The district judge is also called a metropolitan session judge when she or he is proceeding over a district court in a city which is designated as a metropolitan area by the state government. The district judges may be working with the additional district judges depending upon the judicial workload. The district judge is the highest judicial authority below a high court judge. The district court also holds appellate judiciation and the supervision over all the subordinate courts below it. On the civil side, the subordinate courts below the district court include in ascending order Junior Civil Judge Court, Principal Junior Civil Judge Court, Senior Civil Judge Courts also called subcourts, subordinate courts on criminal side in ascending order include second class judicial magistrate courts, the first class judicial magistrate court and chief judicial magistrate court. Apart from the subordinate courts, munishif courts also form a part of this hierarchy. They are the lowest in the terms of handling matters of civil nature and function below the subordinate courts. Their pecuniary limits, meaning the court's ability to hear the matters up to a particular claim for money, are notified by respective state governments. Points to note: a group of judges sitting together on a legal matter in a court constitutes a bench. The lawyers constitute the members at the bar. A division bench comprises of two or three judges. A constitutional bench comprises of five or more judges and may even extend it to 13 judges. Tribunals. Apart from these judicial bodies, Indian judiciary is also characterized by numerous semi-judicial bodies involved in dispute resolution. These bodies function as semi or quasi-judicial bodies because they may consist of administrative officers or judges without a legal background. Yet, they function in their judicial capacity and hear relevant legal matters and settle claims between the parties. Tribunals have been constituted under specific constitutional mandate enshrined in the Constitution of India or through legal enactments, example, law passed by the legislature. Their creation aims at increasing efficiency in resolving disputes and reducing the burden on the courts. Examples of some of these tribunals include Central Administrative Tribunals, CAT, for resolving the grievances and disputes of central government employees, and the State Administrative Tribunal, SAT, for state government employees. Telecom Dispute Settlement Appellate Tribunals, TDSAT, for resolving disputes in telecom sectors in India. And the National Green Tribunal, NGT, for disputes involving environmental issues. Some of these tribunals function with the regulators. Regulators are specialized government agencies that oversee the law and order compliance in the relevant government sectors. For example, one of the tribunals, TDSAT, functions alongside the regulators, TRAI, Telecom Regulatory Authority of India, in formulating laws and policies for resolving telecom disputes in India. Therefore, these tribunals complement and supplement the roles of the courts in maintaining law and justice in the society. Let us ponder. India has no court of appeal unlike the UK. The Law Commission has in its 227th report recommended setting up 4 regional benches of the Supreme Court in Delhi, Chennai, Hyderabad, Kolkata and Mumbai. However, the full court of Supreme Court has rejected the Law Commission's suggestions for establishing a constitutional bench in Delhi and cassation benches in the 4 regions. The Indian Supreme Court hears more than 50,000 cases a year. The UK and US Supreme Courts, on the other hand, hear less than 100 cases a year on average. India, unlike the US, has a unified judicial system. So each state does not have a separate hierarchy of courts that adjudicate the state laws. Discuss the benefits and demerits having the regional benches of Supreme Courts in India. Thank you.